إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونصلي ونسلم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. All praise due to Allah سبحانه وتعالى Almighty. We praise Him and we seek the help from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Whomever Allah guide, no one misguide Him. And whomever misguide, no one will guide him. I be witness and testify, there is no worthy to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Almighty, the Creator, the Sustainer, Al-Khaliq, Al-Raziq, Al-Muhyi, Al-Mumit, Rabbul Alameen. And Muhammad is the last and final messengers. We are up to the scenario of Yawm Al-Qiyamah. And we spoke last lecture about al-as'ila, the questioning, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala start to begin judge the people by gathering them in line. All the mankind, the jinn, the shayateen, the devil, all the creation will be stand on line, very organized. They cannot speak, they will be silent, waiting for the judge by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Almighty. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will gather the messengers and prophet. They will be in front of line. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala start asking the messengers, did you deliver the message? They will answer, oh Allah, you know better, you know the best. Then also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked the nations, did you receive the message? This is how the beginning of the day of judgment. And today, inshallah, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we continue this scenario in more depth. After this scene, what will happen? We start, begin with the ayat from Surah Qaf. You can follow up. Qala ta'ala, from the ayah number 16, Surah Qaf, ayah number 16. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ولقد خلقنا الإنسان ونعلم ما توسوس به نفسه ونحن أقرب إليه من حبل الوريد إذ يتلقى المتلقيان عن اليمين وعن الشمال قعيد ما يلفظ من قول إلا لديه رقيب عتيد وجاءت سكرة الموت بالحق ذلك ما كنت منه تحيد ونفخ في الصور ذلك يوم الوعيد وجاءت كل نفس معها سائق وشهيد لقد كنت في غفلة من هذا فكشفنا عنك غطاءك فبصرك اليوم حديد وقال قرينه هذا ما لدي عتيد ألقيا في جهنم كل كفار عنيد مناع للخير معتد مريب الذي جعل مع الله إلها آخر فألقياه في العذاب الشديد. الله سبحانه وتعالى in this surah, this surah, Surah Qaf, one of the most amazing surah in the Quran, reminding the people. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, peace be upon him, He used to deliver خطبة الجمعة and he used to recite so much time, so many times Surah Qaf. And the Sahaba in the narration, they said, we memorize Surah Qaf because Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم, he used to recite it so many times in خطبة الجمعة, Friday. As telling us that خطبة الجمعة, it's a reminder, it's a wake up call, reminding the reality about the hereafter, about the purpose of life, about the next life, about akhirat. In this ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described وَجَاءَتْ سَكْرَةُ الْمَوْتِ بِالْحَقَّ ذَلِكَ مَا كُنْتَ مِنْهُ تَحِيدٌ. Every person, every soul run away and wish to run away from this moment of death. Every person is scared from this moment because this moment is very pain, full of pain. Allah subhanahu describes sakratul maut. The person in the moment of death, he's like a drunk, out of pain. And subhanallah, in this moment, if a person can scream, he will scream loudly and hardly. But the pain is inside his body. He cannot explain to you. He's indifferent feeling. He's indifferent world. The Salaf al-Salih, they said, the moment of death is like you cutting finger 300 times from your body. How pain the person is, you know, subhanAllah, suffering the death. But he cannot speak loudly. He is conscious sometimes. This is called sakaratul maut. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy on us and give us the strength and give us the ability to say la ilaha illallah before we die. And this is a kalimatul tawheed, the word of ikhlas, the word of oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kalimatul tawheed, whomever is the last word from this dunya, la ilaha illallah, دخل الجنة. He will be enter shurga or enter paradise, enter the heaven. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us and give us the iman in this moment. And this is how important al-aqidatu awwalan law kanu ya'lamun. How important is the faith is first if the people know. Only the true mu'min, true believer who believe in Allah, he's his creator, his sustainer, his ibadah, only all that his life, his ibadah, he were doing for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with ikhlas and sincerity. So in this moment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reveal the malaikatul rahma on him. Okay? تَدَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ إن الذين قالوا ربنا الله ثم استقاموا تتنزل عليهم الملائكة. سبحان الله. Those who say ربنا الله, our Lord is Allah, our Lord is Almighty, Allah one God, تتنزل عليهم. The angels come group by group over them. تتنزل عليهم الرحمة, the mercy come upon them. So Allah سبحانه وتعالى will help them in this moment of death. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him the ability to say the kalimatul tawheed. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give it to us. And qala ta'ala, وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. And don't die except in the state of Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we ask Allah with the full of sincerity, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us die in the state of Islam. سبحان الله. Okay, let's continue. ونفخ في الصور ذلك يوم الوعيد. Allah سبحانه وتعالى describing the يوم القيامة. When is blow in the horn. سبحان الله. ذلك يوم الوعيد. That day is the promised, the threat. سبحان الله. Allah, when Allah سبحانه وتعالى Almighty promise something, that promise is not 50%. Is not 80%, is not 99%. the promise of Allah 100% will come without any single doubt. وَمَنْ أَصْدَقُ مِنَ اللَّهِ حَدِيثًا. Who is better and who is more truthful than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? No one. وَمَنْ أَصْدَقُ مِنَ اللَّهِ قِيلًا. Allah, when He promised something, surely will come. Surely will happen without any doubtful. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described that moment of death, then move to the يوم القيامة. قال قرينه هذا ما لدي عتيد. Because each person, he has angel in his right hand, رقيب, an angel in his left hand, عتيد, and رقيب, he's ordered to write all your good deeds. And عتيد, he's been ordered to write all your bad deeds. So always remember, someone is writing, registering. Subhanallah. So when you all the time remember that the angel is writing your things, you try your best to be in state of ibadah, on ta'a, obedience, on remembrance, in goodness, and band yourself from the haram and disobedience. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us and give us the iman. مَنَّاعِ لِلْخَيْرِ مُعْتَدٍ مُرِيبٍ الَّذِي جَعَلَ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَهًا آخَرٍ فَأَلْقِيَاهُ فِي الْعَذَابِ الشَّدِيدِ. Here Allah declared to us those group of people who involve in shirk, whom associate partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whom they believe God other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or beside Allah, whom they seek God other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those they will be thrown in the severe punishment. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. قَالَ قَرِينُهُ رَبَّنَا مَا أَضْغَيْتُهُ وَلَكِنْ كَانَ فِي ضَلَالٍ بَعِيدٍ. Here the devil, he claimed that I did not misguide him. He was in misguide. And this is the story of the devil. Allah mentioned another surah Al-Hijr. وقال الشيطان لما قضي الأمر إن الله وعدكم وعد الحق ووعدتكم فأخلفتكم وما كان لي عليكم من سلطان إلا أن دعوتكم فاستجبتم لي فلا تلوموني ولوموا أنفسكم ما أنا بمصرخكم وما أنتم بمصرخي. وقال الشيطان, the شيطان, the devil. وقال الشيطان لما قضي الأمر. الشيطان will speak after everything done. The people, the believer, the people of Jannah, they will be in Jannah. The people of hellfire, they will be in hellfire. And the shaitan, the devil, he is in hellfire. And they start coming to him. Because of you, because of you, because of you. Then shaitan, he said, وَمَا لِيَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ سُلْطَانِ. I don't have power upon you or over you, except I invited you and you answered my call. Don't blame myself. Blame yourself. فَلَا تَلُومُونِ وَلُومُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. Blame yourself. ما أنا بمصرخكم وما أنتم بمصرخي إني كفرت بما أشركتموني من قبل. Now I disbelieve in all type of shirk, and I disbelieve with all those slaves, the one they worship me and obey me. I disbelieve in it and I cannot help you anymore. Go away. That is the answer of the devil. He promised them and he did not fulfill the promise. And you know the promise of shaitan is fake one. And the promise of Ar-Rahman is the true one. So if you know the promise of Ar-Rahman, Allah Almighty, the Merciful, is true, why you go to the way of the promise of the devil? Devil promised you all fake, all wrong. He declared to you the wrong and tell you fool in it. Subhanallah. And this is how those people, the when they follow the devil way, wallahi, before the akhirat, before the hereafter, they, shaitan will lead them to the hard and bad life. Look at those people, they fall in drugs. They will be in poorness. The money finished. They start bagging money. They start stealing. They will end up in jail. They will be in bad name in front of the family. And etc. صح. This is a devil way. He declared to you the drugs. For the youth I'm talking. Then shaitan come to you, declared to you, take a loan with the interest. You know, let your family have a good life. Then miskin, the father, he go and take with the interest, with the haram. Then he will be suffered 15 to 20 years working like animal to pay the bank. And when 2 years he cannot work, he gets sick, he cannot pay the bank, the house going to the bank. Then he lost his money. And he will have a hard life. And he will win or earn the anger of Allah. I'm talking about who take the loan with the haram. I'm not talking about the one he follow the Sharia way. This is how shaitan love that you will be in hard life or miserable life. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us. Okay. Then we move to the other ayat about this scenario of the question of the day of the judgment. قال تعالى يقول الإنسان يومئذ أين المفر كلا لا وزر إلى ربك يومئذ المستقر. In Surah Al-Qiyamah, قال تعالى لا أقسم بيوم القيامة ولا أقسم بالنفس اللوامة. Allah swear by the day of resurrection, by the day of Qiyamah, by the يوم القيامة. ولا أقسم بالنفس اللوامة until we reach the ayah where we want to show you. وجوه يومئذ ناظرة إلى ربها ناظرة. Some of the faces that day will be shining, lightening, blooming, full of light. إلى ربها ناظرة, looking at their Lord. ووجوه يومئذ باسرة تظن أن يفعل بها فاقرة. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among of the wujuh yawma idhin nadira. And another ayat here, qala ta'ala, ayah number 10, you can see ayah number 10, yaqulu al-insanu yawma idhin ayna al-mafar kalla la wazar ila rabbika yawma idhin al-mustaqar. يقول الإنسان يومئذ أين المفر. Man will say on the day, where is the place of escape? Where is the place of escape? كلا لا وزر, there is no refuge. إلى ربك يومئذ المستقر. To your Lord, that day is the place of permanence. الله أكبر. So, subhanAllah, this ayat, it's a reality that we all going to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We all going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no running away from this. And the hadith from the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the hadith sahih, Imam Muslim, number of the hadith, 1016. You can write it down. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم ما منكم من أحد إلا سيكلمه الله. No one among you, no one from you, not even single person, إلا except Allah will speak to him directly. ليس بينه وبينه ترجمان. There is no any translator between him and Allah. يا الله. We all going to stand in front of Allah, going to ask us without any translator. Allahu Akbar. That is really amazing moment. فينظر أيمن منه فلا يرى إلا ما قدم. Then the person, he look at in his right, he will see all what he did. وينظر أشأم منه فلا يرى إلا ما قدم. Then he look at in his left, he saw all what he done. وينظر بين يديه فلا يرى إلا النار تلقاء وجهه. And he look at in front of him, between his hand, he will see the hellfire in front of him. And the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith, فاتقوا النار ولو بشق تمرة. Fear the hellfire even with a part of date. A part of date mean you give in the path of Allah. Not date, well, not one date, half. If you find a half of date in order to give it as a sadaqah, donation, because you fear from the punishment of Allah and the hellfire, do so. Allahu Akbar. فَاتَّقُوا النَّارَ وَلَوْ بِشَقِّ تَمْرَةٍ. سبحان الله. وَلَوْ بِكَلِمَةٍ طَيِّبَةٍ. And even in the utter or a good word you say. Good word. Your niyyah, your attention with this good word to be protected and to be, you are afraid from the punishment of Allah or afraid from the hellfire. A word, only a word, single word. How cheap is? يعني if one day you have a calculator and you try your best to calculate all the word you utter. يعني ما, I don't think so. In one day, less than 1,000 words you speak. From this 1,000 word, have some niyyah that you speak a good in order to protect yourself from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is it true? Is it true, sisters and brother? That's what we need. We need to little bit have some fearness towards Allah. Subhanallah, if we every day talk about dinghy, oh, we are afraid from this dinghy. If people talk about tsunami, we are afraid from tsunami. But we are afraid from all this what propaganda talking, and we are not afraid from the hellfire, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned to us in the Quran and warning us. So it's a reminder to us to protect ourselves from the punishment of Allah. قال الفضيل بن عياض, one of the تابعين, one of the amazing تابعين, and he has an amazing story. That فضيل بن عياض, you know what his story? He was a leader of the thief. He was a leader of the thief. And one time, they are in the middle of the way, any caravan pass by, they come and attack and they take the things. So they saw the caravan, they come and him and his group. They attacked the caravan, they took everything, and they tied the people. So he was the leader of the thieves. So when he passed by one, the one they tied, he passed by one young child. And he said, the child spoke to him, he's not afraid. He said to him, I saw all your worker, or all your servant, whatever, the one thief with you, they are eating from the caravan, but you don't eat, why? He said, I'm fasting. Subhanallah. Then the gun, he said, you're fasting and you are the leader of the thieves. And the Fudail bin Iyad, he said a word. He said, yes, I am in state of major sin, but I will not cut the rope between me and Allah. Fudail bin Iyad, later on, he repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they found him in Mecca seeking knowledge, and he become one of the amazing alim. He wrote so many books, Al-Fudail bin Iyad, and subhanallah, he has so much iman. Look at Those people, they doesn't cut the between the relationship between them and Allah. Whatever they doing from this sin or mistake, they still in state of iman and faith and love and fear towards Allah. Fudail bin Iyad, he said to the man, كم مضى من عمرك? How many years pass from your lifetime? He said, he replied, 60 years. He said, Al-Fudail, فَأَنْتَ مُنْذُ 60 عَامًا تَسِيرُ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ. You were, before 60 years ago, you are walking towards your Lord. And you are very soon going to reach. فقال الرجل, إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. فقال الفضيل, أتعرف تفسيره؟ تقول إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. Do you understand what the meaning of tafsir of what did you say? إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. فمن علم أن لله عبد, whomever knew that he is a servant to Allah, and one day he is coming back to his master, and he will stand in the front of him. And whomever knew that he will stand in front of him, he will be questioned by his master. And whomever knew he will be questioned by master, he has to prepare the answer for his master. Allahu Akbar. So this is a just reminder from Fudail bin Iyad to this young man. You knew you're going back to your Lord from 60 years ago. Did you prepare for his when the moment you stand in front of him? Did you prepare that the answer, what you should answer him? Subhanallah. Something wallahi, you know, shake the heart. Wallahi, we need. Many of us, we go to so many classes seeking knowledge. But sometimes that knowledge doesn't, you know, give us more feeling towards our Lord. We need our heart to be refreshed. Make that knowledge make us closer to Allah. Fear Allah. Hope what Allah have. Make us more grieving and closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Grieving for all kind of ibadah and worship. Subhanallah. So, after that, the people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يُبَشِّرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. يُبَشِّر mean glad tiding, a good news. قال تعالى فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِهِ فَسَوْفَ يُحَاسَبُ حِسَابًا يَسِيرًا. Whom receive his book with his right hand, he will be questioned, easy question, easy way. حِسَابًا يَسِيرًا, very light questioning. وينقلب إلى أهله مسرورا, and he will return back to his family happy and joy. So for the believer, the worshipper, the good person, he will be in ease يوم القيامة. وقال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, peace be upon him, in the hadith, and this hadith صحيح البخاري 2309 and Sahih Muslim 2768. قال رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله يدني المؤمن فيضع عليه كنفه ويستره. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make closer the believer, make him closer towards him. ويستره, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cover him from the awwal mankind. So the believer, the true believer, he will be mastur. What is mean mastur? Mean being his mistake will be covered from the eye of other mankind. And this is a ni'mah. Wallahi, 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 we all don't like to be our mistake will be exposed in front of people. Even in front of two, three men. Sometimes we become angry if a person knew my mistake. One person. How about all mankind? All mankind, from jinn, from human being, from the malaika. Can you imagine if one of your mistakes exposed yawm al-qiyamah in front of all mankind? How hard is it? wallahi, for me, this is enough punishment. Just exposing our mistakes, subhanAllah, in front of all mankind. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yada'u kanafahu wa yastru. Allah will cover that from the people. So only the believer and Allah. Allah talking to him. Ata'arifu dhanba kadha? Ata'arifu dhanba kadha? Do you know the mistake and the sin? The one you did it this so such. Then يعني, he mentioned Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala what he did. So and so. فيقول نعم أي رب. Yes, my Lord, I knew. حتى إذا قرره بذنوبه. Until that believer, he will be يعني قرره. Mean قرره يعني he understood 100%. He is really mistaken and in error and in sin. And he felt he lost. And he will feel as he lost, as he going to Jahannam. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. That the believer. Allah will say to him, سَتَرْتُهَا عَلَيْكَ فِي الدُّنْيَا. I cover that sin or that mistake in the time of dunya. وَأَنَا أَغْفِرُهَا لَكَ الْيَوْمِ. And today I forgive it. I forgive it. Today I forgive it. فَيُعْطَى كِتَابَ حَسَنَاتِ. Then he will be receive his book, his good deeds. Allahu Akbar. And the hadith is long. This is just a part of it. Can you imagine how the believer will be? For that, now I'm talking about in depth questioning. Allah will make the believer closer to him, and Allah will cover that conversation from the eye of all people between him and Allah. Then he will ask him, did you know when you fall in this sin and this sin and this sin, until he be khalas, the believer, I did it, I am now lost, losing. He's going to punishment of Allah. Then what will happen? In that moment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Almighty, the Merciful, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, قال, سَتَرْتُهَا عَلَيْكَ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَأَغْفِرُهَا لَكَ الْيَوْمِ. I cover your sin or mistake today, and I will forgive her for you today. Then, subhanallah, he will receive his book, Good Deeds. And this is the answer for this ayat. I will show you to you, Surah Al-Haqqa.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. فأما من أوتي كتابه بيمينه.
آية نمبر 19. So as for he whom is giving his record in his right hand, he will say, here, read my record. Here, read my record.
إني ظننت أني ملاق حسابي.
Indeed, I was certain that I would be meeting my account. سبحان الله. He will be judged.
فهو في عيشة راضية.
So he will be in pleasant life.
في جنة عالية.
In elevated garden.
قطوفها دانية.
Its fruit to be picked, hang near. Allahu Akbar. So this is the believer. Let's jump next scenario about the disbeliever. How his question.
وَأَمَّا الْكَافِرُ وَالْمُجْرِمُ.
The evil, the criminal, the disbeliever. فَيُوقِفُهُ اللَّهُ عَلَى رُؤُوسِ الْخَلَائِقِ. Allah will made him stand in front of all mankind. لا يستره ولا يحجبه. He will not be under the sitr, under the cover. He will be exposed to all mankind. The question in front of all mankind. ليفضح أمره ثم يقول الله عز وجل. Allah will speak to the kafir, the disbeliever, to the criminal. أي عبدي, oh my servant, عملت يوم كذا كذا وكذا. You did this and this and this that day. فيقول الكافر وعزتك وجلالك. By you honor, oh my Lord, oh يا الله, I did not do that. ويظن المسكين, and he believe the miskin one, he can lie in that day. He have ability to lie. ويظن أن يكذب كما كان يكذب في الدنيا. قال تعالى يوم يبعثهم الله جميعا فيحلفون له كما يحلفون لكم ويحسبون أنهم على شيء. سورة المجادلة آية 18. You can go. Amazing ayat. Wallahi, I'm trying to focus in my classes talking from Quran and Hadith. I don't want to bring to you so many weak narration or stories or whatever. I'm trying to focus from the Quran, so it's very easy for you to look and take advantage and memorize it, and it's a wake-up call for yourself and for the people surrounding you, inshallah, and for us. طيب, this ayah 18, يوم يبعثهم. The top in the board. قال تعالى, on the day Allah will resurrect them, all of them, and they will swear to him as they swear to you and think they are standing on something. ألا إنهم هم الكاذبون. Indeed they are the in big lie. They will lie. سبحان الله. Then, يا عبدي عملت يوم كذا وكذا وكذا. فيقول وعزتك وجلالك يا رب ما عملت. فيقول الله, after Allah سبحانه وتعالى, you did this and this and that. He said, والله, by your honor, I did not do. Then Allah will say to him, عبدي, oh my servant, who will witness for you? من يشهد عليك? Who will witness for you? يريد الكافر والمجرم أن يجيب هو بنفسه. Then the evil, the criminal, he will say, I don't accept witness except from myself. Because maybe if he asks any human being or any person, they will be against him. So he said, I only accept the witness from myself. Then فيقول الله سبحانه وتعالى, قال تعالى, فالله سبحانه وتعالى order his tongue will be sealed, and his hand and his skin and his foot and his stomach, his body, starting talking against him and witness against him. Allahu Akbar. Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah. This is a moment is really, really amazing. How come this is will happen? He said, I will accept only a witness from myself. Then his tongue will be sealed, and his skin, his hand, his foot, his foot, all they will witness against him. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. قال تعالى سورة ياسين آية 65, and you all know سورة ياسين. اليوم نختم على أفواههم وتكلمنا أيديهم وتشهد أرجلهم بما كانوا يكسبون. سبحان الله. اليوم نختم على أفواههم وتكلمنا أيديهم وتشهد أرجلهم بما كانوا يكسبون. آية 65. The day نختم على أفواههم, their tongue will be sealed, وتكلمنا أيديهم, and their hand will speak, وتشهد أرجلهم بما كانوا يكسبون. here the ayah 65 in the top in the board. That day we will seal over their mouths, and their hands will speak to us, and their feet will testify about what they used to err. Allah Akbar. Then فتظن الأيادي والأفخاذ والأرجل والسمع والبصر الكل يشهد بما عمل. Subhanallah, all they witness, the hand, the foot, everything, all the one he used to do earn from haram, they will speak in that day. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala release his tongue to speak. Then he say, Al-kullu yashhad. Then that the criminal, the evil, he talk to his skin. Why you witness against me? Why you witness against me? I defend so you will be safe, you will be protected. Subhanallah. And you can analyze this ayat with the Surah Fussilat. Surah Fussilat, very talking about details in this moment. Wallahi, يعني read the ayat in depth. Here. Ayah 20, you can follow. I will recite in Arabic, you can go with the English. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. حتى إذا ما جاءوها شهد عليهم سمعهم وأبصارهم وجلودهم بما كانوا يعملون. Ayah 21. وقالوا لجلودهم لما شهدتم علينا قالوا أنطقنا الله الذي أنطق كل شيء وهو خلقكم أول مرة وإليه ترجعون. سبحان الله. You can go to number 22 also. وما كنتم تستترون أن يشهد عليكم سمعكم ولا أبصاركم ولا جلودكم ولكن ظننتم أن الله لا يعلم كثيرا مما تعملون وذلكم ظنكم الذي ظننتم بربكم أرداكم فأصبحتم من الخاسرين فإن يصبروا فالنار مثوى لهم وإن يستعتبوا فما هم من المعتبين. From ayah 20 to 24, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describing those people when Yawm al-Qiyamah they witness against them, their skin, subhanallah, and their ear and their sight. Sight can speak, ear can speak, skin can speak. Allahu Akbar. Then he said, why you witness against me? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qalu antaqan, they will speak to him back. Allah made us speak, the one he made everything can speak. Wa huwa khalaqakum awwala marra, and indeed he created you before, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have power to give us the ability to speak. Wama kuntum tastatiruna ay yashhad alaykum sam'ukum, then Allah talking to them, you try to hiding that your skin, your ear, your sight will not speak against you, and you thought that Allah does not know what did you did. You were in state that believing that Allah not aware about what did you done. Allahu Akbar. وَذَلِكُمْ, because of that thought, أَرْدَاكُمْ, you will be a loser. And look at the last ayah, wallahi. Look at the final destination in the last ayah, number 24. فَإِن يَصْبِرُوا فَالنَّارُ مَثْوًى لَهُمْ وَإِن يَسْتَعْتِبُوا فَمَا هُمْ مِنَ الْمُعْتَبِينَ. Ya Allah, ayat amazing. فَإِن يَصْبِرُوا, even if they are impatient, the fire will be resident for them. And if they ask for a peace, Allah, they will be not beat from those who will be allowed to peace. Subhanallah. Khalas. This is the final destination for them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us and protect us. Wallahi, brothers and sisters, don't look at the dunya from the fake picture. They always announce the kuffar, the one he's a criminal, the disbeliever, they are in joy, they are in happiness, and they try to drive other people with the fake ideas, subhanAllah, fake belief, and decorate the belief, the fake, the stupid belief, subhanAllah, the one they have, they try to decorate it by the name of culture, by the name of, I don't know how to say it, wallahi, this is will all perish. Nothing will be remain yawm al-qiyam.
طيب, here we have a question. Many people, they have this question. Is the kuffar, the disbeliever, will be questioned? Or they will be dragging straight away to hellfire? Because the kafir, he's already in state of disbelief. So why he has to go for questions? So the ulama, they have different opinion with this. One of the ulama, they said, Al-kuffar la yus'alun, they will not be in accounting, they will be not be in questioning. Straight away they, from the land of the resurrection, they will be dragging to the hellfire, because there's no worse sin than disbelief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or make fool in shirk. And they said the dalil, قال تعالى وَلَا يُسْأَلُ عَنْ ذُنُوبِهِمُ الْمُجْرِمُونَ. There's an ayah, the mujrimun, the criminal, they will not be questioning about their evil. Yani in other words, they will be throwing in the hellfire, the criminal. But the other opinion from the ulama, and this is more authentic, that even the kuffar, who in state of not iman, they will be questioned and they will be accounted. قال تعالى اليوم تجزى كل نفس ما كسبت. The day each single person will be received what he earned, what he did. Subhanallah. وَقِفُوهُمْ إِنَّهُمْ مَسْئُولُونَ. Allah will order the angel, وَقِفُوهُمْ, let them stand, they will be in question. They will be going to through questioning. And Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, إن أَنَّ الْإِنسَانِ يُوزَنُ فِي الْمِيزَانِ مَعْ عَمَالِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also mentioned the Quran and the Hadith that every single person, he will be, his good deeds or his deeds will be scaled. So this is also type of process of questioning. So how to answer this? The answer, they will be in question, the kuffar, even the kuffar. And the dalil, first of all, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to put the hujjah over them. What is mean hujjah? Mean the clear evidence. Clear dalil, clear evidence. قال تعالى ووضع الكتاب فترى المجرمين مشفقين مما فيه ويقولون يا ويلتنا ما لهذا الكتاب لا يغادر صغيرة ولا كبيرة إلا أحصى. And when the book will be وضع, يعني will be given الكتاب, سبحان الله, فترى المجرمين, and you will see the criminal, the مجرمين, the كفار, they will be مشفقين, they will be in terror. ويقولون يا ويلتنا, why over us? This book, every small or big, it's written inside. لا يغادر صغيرة ولا كبيرة إلا أحصاها. Another دليل, سبحان الله, فاعترفنا بذنوبنا فهل إلى خروج من سبيل. After those people dragged into the hellfire and they are in punishment, later they will say, we declare that we are sinner, we declare that we are in wrong, so is any way so we can come out? So this is also hujja on them, subhanAllah. Before they try to lie, mucking around, but when they are in the punishment, wal'iyadu billah, they said, khalas, we are declared that we are wrong, so is any way to go out? So this is also mentioned Surah Ghafir. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also questioning them in order expose their mistakes. And as scolding them, subhanallah. وَلَوْ تَرَى إِذْ وُقِفُوا عَلَىٰ رَبِّكَ. Oh Muhammad, if you seen they will, those disbeliever, the enemy of Islam, standing in front of their Lord. قال أليس هذا بالحق? Is this is the truth? Allah will say to them. They say, بلى وربنا. Yes. And they swear by the name of their Lord. Now, قال فذوقوا العذاب ما كنتم تكفرون. So go and taste the punishment because you were liar before. Subhanallah. Also, this is, it's a type of punishment. When a person will be scolded in front of all mankind. Allahu Akbar. May Allah protect us. And also the disbeliever also been ordered to follow the Sharia. Okay? For example, Qala Ta'ala, okay, we can analyze this ayat from Surah Al-Muddathir. Surah Al-Muddathir. You realize most of the surah, we talk about Yawm Al-Qiyamah from the last in the Quran. The small, all ayat surah Makkiyah came, subhanAllah, warning the kuffar and establish the iman and the faith on the heart of the people. Surah Al-Muddathir.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ما سلككم في سقر قالوا لم نك من المصلين ولم نك نطعم المسكين
Ayah 42, you can see from the top of the board. قال تعالى ما سلككم في سقر and asking them what put you into سقر. سقر, brothers and sisters, is one of the levels in hellfire. Hellfire, it has a darakat layer. والجنة have درجات also layer, but in Arabic we say درجات ودركات. درجات mean layer to the high. وجهنم والعذب لا دركات mean layer to down. So the first one is جهنم and the second, the حطمة, السعير, الجحيم, one of the layer of جهنم والعذب الله. So سقر is one of the layer in جهنم والعذب الله, in hellfire. ما سلككم في سقر قالوا لم نكن من المصلين. They will say we were not of those whom prayed. Ya Allah, Ya Allah. This ayah, wallahi, very touching for the Muslims, brothers and sisters, whom abandoned the salat. Wallahi, from the ummah now, so many youth abandoning the salat. Abandoning the salat. They are not doing salat at maybe sometimes or very rare. May Allah forgive us. وَلَمْ نَكُنْ نُطْعِمُ الْمِسْكِينَ nor did we use to feed the poor. So we did not give the poor, the miskeen. Also, this is one of the sharia. وَكُنَّا نَخُوضُ مَعَ الْخَائِضِينَ and we used to enter into vain discourse with those who engaged. So we will be with the people of the bad and evil and make fun and mock on the deen of Allah. حَتَّى أَتَى وَكُنَّا نُكَذِّبُ بِيَوْمِ الدِّينِ and we used to deny the day of resurrection or the day of يوم القيامة. حَتَّى أَتَانَ الْيَقِينِ until there came to us the yaqeen, the truthful. فما تنفعهم شفاعة الشافعين. So there is no intercession will help them in يوم القيامة. Subhanallah. This ayat, it's clear to us that even who is in state of not iman, he been ordered for the Sharia to do salah, to help the poor, to do these things. They will be punished if they receive the message and they denied and they did not go for it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we said, يُحَاسِبُهُمْ وَيَسْأَلُهُمْ لِأَنَّ النَّارَ دَرَكَاتٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will questioning them Because in Jahannam, in hellfire, there is layer. So not all the kuffar in one state. One kafir is very evil, very criminal, very bad. He will be in lower layer, lower place in hellfire, wal'iyadhu billah. And do you know, brothers and sisters, whom they are the lowest of all, among of all people in hellfire, the lowest layer? المنافقون. قال تعالى إن المنافقين في الدرك الأسفل من النار ولن تجد لهم نصيرا. إن المنافقين, indeed the hypocrite منافقين, whom they hide the kufr and they show the iman, they will be in the lowest, والعياذ بالله, دركات, درك, درك, lowest layer in hellfire. Lowest layer in the hellfire for the hypocrite and whom, wal'iyadhu billah, mocking on ad-deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah save us from those. So from here, if anybody says, okay, the kuffar, they already in state of not iman, so they should straight away go to hellfire, said, no, the true answer, they go for questioning, and between the kuffar, they will be different level in hellfire. Like Abu Talib, the uncle of Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he has iman in his heart and he did all kind of good, but he didn't declare that shahadat al-tawheed, so he will be in the lowest level in the he will be the lowest punishment, the lowest punishment in the hellfire, subhanallah, according to the hadith. So the one in the lowest in punishment in the hellfire, he thinking he is in the worst punishment. How about the people in the middle of the hellfire or in the lowest part in the hellfire? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us and protect us, subhanallah. So what is the benefit out of this class? Let us summarize that every single person, he will be in the question facing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without translator, and in this moment, he, if he is among of the believer and good, he will be inshallah question is in ease, and he will be come back to his family full of happiness, and he will receive his book in the right hand. But the evil, the criminal, the bad, the kafir, he will be receive his book in hell in left, and also he will be exposed his sin in front of mankind, and he will be dragged to the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Jahannam. This is the scenario of the questioning in Yawm al-Qiyamah. Next week, inshallah, if Allah give us life, we will be also continue the scenario number 10, talking about how one type of people will be questioned. One type of people, I will not mention to you now. Let's see and find out who those people and how they will be questioned in Yawm al-Qiyamah with the next scenario and next picture from the day of judgment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us and protect us. Wallahi, this series, it's a waking up for us. Inshallah, I hope that words will enter our heart, not comes from one ear and goes out from the other ear. It comes and remember all the time, and more that will be going through the question of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so we will be doing more good deeds, more closer to Allah, and repent to Allah every day, and we will be inshallah in state of iman. And wallahi, how beautiful if we all here in this class gather in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Jannah, and we remember this remembrance. Wallahi, it's so beautiful. So that's how we want to recharge our heart, recharge our iman, in order, subhanallah, to achieve the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma nas'aluka ya akram al-akramin, wa ya arham al-rahimin, wa ya ghiyath al-mustaghifin, wa ya rabb al-mustad'afin, wa ya rahima al-du'afai wal-masakin, ya man arsalta ilayna sayyid al-mursaleen, Muhammadin alayhi afdal salati wa tamu taslim. Nas'aluka an taj'alana mimman yuhasabu hisaban yasira وينقلب إلى أهلي مسرورا, وممن يأخذ كتابه بيمينه فيقول ها أم اقرأوا كتابيه, ممن تبت عليهم وغفرت لهم ورحمتهم وجعلت آخر كلامهم من الدنيا شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. اللهم أحينا على الإيمان وأمتنا على الإيمان والإسلام، ولا تخزنا يوم القيامة ويوم العرض عليك. اللهم ظلنا في ظل عرشك يوم لا ظل إلا ظلك. اللهم احشرنا مع نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين، وحسن أولئك رفيقا. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لكوننا من الخاسرين. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. We still have a 5 minutes, so it's open question if you have any question. Yes, sister, بسم الله. Okay, for the Zakil Akhir, very nice question. Sister asking how we deal with the young brothers and sisters, young people, they surrounding them all kind of fitna and haram, and subhanAllah, it's a test. So how we can approach them to be a pious and good. So brothers and sisters, the first of the, you have to understand, youth, this is very dangerous age, which most of the youth, they are wishing and trying to be independent. They want to be independent life, they have their own private life. So many of the parents, they try to involve in all their lives until the clash, until when you give them advices or nasiha, they will not accept. And this is wrong technique of da'wah. The good technique of da'wah, teach them, try to plant the iman in their heart, and let them do between them and Allah. Train them that Allah watching them wherever they go. Training them that the malaika write everything, single things. Also try to establish a good environment for them, good friend. The friendship is very important. Many of us, we don't care that my daughter, she has any kind of friend, or my son, any kind of friend. No. Try to analyze and select the good friend, good environment. Involve them in the masjid, environment of da'wah. Let them be part of that, with a sister doing da'wah or activity for Islam. So this is always recharge their iman. But when I allow them to go wherever they like to go, have bad friend, do this and that, of course later on they will not listen to you. This one point. Another point, choose the right time to give nasiha. Many of us, we give nasiha all the time until the child, oh, this is my mother old in mind. Oh, she cannot understand our lifestyle now. This is many times wrong from the mother and father. You have to understand the environment outside, and not all the time give nasiha every day from morning until night. Of course he will be irritated. Choose the right moment. Make him closer to you. Don't give nasiha in front of others. Try, go and your daughter, drink 2 coffee and talk to her, remind her, my daughter, this is what is haram, this is what is right, this is what Muslim should do. Tell her some nice story about the whom went the wrong way and they failed, and whom they went the right way and they success. This is the strong relationship between the mother and the young child, and the mother and the young daughter. This really, really established friendship. The ulama, they says, 7 years play with the child, 7 years you, what do you call, educate him or her, and discipline them. The second 7 years, what is the total? 14. And 7 years befriend with them, How many parents they are lack of to be his son or daughter as a friend? Joke with him. Your son hit him from the back like this. Make him as a friendship. Hold him. Talk to him. Go with him. A trip. Refresh. Let him feel you are the close friend to him. Nothing wrong. Maybe you hear some unpolite word towards you. Just forget it. And don't be like, so I am father, he has to kiss my hand all the time. Not that. Be a friend with him and protect him from the bad shaitan environment outside. This is really, really important. Subhanallah. Be friend with your daughter. Let her open her heart to you to tell you all her problem. This is really important. Many of us, we are lack of understanding these things. Until we found our children, we cannot control them anymore, and we lost them. Subhanallah. Brothers and sisters, the fitna is not easy. So you have to create a good environment, iman environment. Take them to Quran class, take them to tahfiz, take them with the da'wah activities, take them to this, establish them, put some lectures in Bahasa Malayu, let's say, reminder. Make a small bookstore in your house to read the nice book. Changing. Human being dislike, what do you call it? Boring etiquette or everyday, daily things. Same, everyday same things. They like to be new things in the house. New things, always new things. So this is subhanAllah, we should understand. And in the end, sister Dua. Do you remember the story when a young man, very young man, strong, Arabic person, mashallah, in the time of Arabia, not now, now it's fake. I'm talking about the time where they are strong, they live in desert. They came to Rasulullah and he said, Ya Rasulullah, I believe in Islam, but allow me to go for fornication, for zina. Astaghfirullah, who you are talking to? You come to the Prophet of Allah to ask him to allow you for zina, fornication? Nabi Sallallahu, he did not say to him, haram, you will be in hellfire, you will be a wrongdoer. Did he use that technique? He's a young man. If he tell him like this way, he might run away from Islam. What did Nabi Sallallahu use? Do you know the hadith? He said, oh young man, do you allow that to your sister? Astaghfirullah. My sister, somebody touch her, I'll kill her. You know, the how come? This is jealousy. Nabi Sallam used this technique. أترضاه لأختك؟ قال لا. أترضاه لأمك؟ Do you allow this happen to your mother? He said, لا. No. أترضاه. He said, والله I come out from Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the most beloved to my heart, zina. And I come out, the most hated things is a zina. He give him the right medicine. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is the doctor of the hearts. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this is also, you have to understand the right technique, da'wah way. To your young. Of course, nasiha to the young, different about nasiha about the old. Like your friend here in the Aysan, you see her make it wrong. Different when you give her da'wah than young man. Also child, every stage, it has a technique way. And wallahi, the hidayah is by Allah's hand. Wallahi, if every day you use all kind of technique, if the will of Allah will not guide them, you cannot do anything. So what you can do, dua to Allah. Rabbi ja'alni muqim as-salati wa min dhurriyati rabbana wa taqabbal dua. Dua to them, oh Allah, make me muqim as-salati, perform the salah, and from my children, from my dhurriya. Oh Allah, taqabbal dua, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide our children and save them and protect them from haram and from fitna and make them a good Muslim and pious. Ameen, ameen, ya Rab. Any other question? No, any question? Taim, jazakum Allah khair. Any comment you like to share with us? After? Six of January, inshallah, next class, by the will of Allah. I hope you announce to young. I want more young to come our class. So let them feel the environment. Da'wah is not only you receive to yourself. Don't be selfish. ask your neighbor. يعني والله I say, every person he come to YSN, Ya Ta'aleem, he brought one person from the street or from the environment of dunya to the listen to lecture. He will get his reward, and wallahi the da'wah will be expanded. Subhanallah. This is what inshallah we need to bring the youth to the good environment which they can listen to the word of Allah and the reminder, so they will have the subhanallah, the iman. I would like to end up with a small story. One subhanallah lady, she was very smart. I forget the details of the story, but a person, he's listening to music, haram one, you know, the haram one. And when she went, she has to travel with him long journey. He said to her, I want to put the music. She's religious, he knew. She said, okay, no problem. We can divide the time. She was smart in da'wah. Said, all right, you put, let's say, 2 hours, 1 hour music, and allow me to put something I like in 1 hour. He said, all right. His time, he put the music. Sorry, I think she said, but can I start with mine? I think that's the story. Then he said to her, yes, she already prepared very nice lectures. Talk about subhanallah, up call, touching one. She played. Of course, he's driving, he's listening. Subhanallah, from that lecture, he repented to Allah and he said, I don't want to listen to music anymore. So let also يعني, those people receive the da'wah or the wake up call. Subhanallah. So in order to, you know, the heart sometimes become hardened, need to be a reminder. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi used to give also a reminder to the Sahaba. So this is what we need also. Reminder for ourselves and for the others. Jazakum Allahu khairan wa ahsanallahu alaykum. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.